What's up guys, Dan from Dan the Main Gaming, and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be doing a squad builder, and yes, it is on FIFA 16. This is only the web app, as I don't have the game just yet, and I don't have an Elgato anyway to record the gameplay, so you won't be getting anything till Christmas because I'm going to be getting it out. But if there is any videos, it'll be on the web app, and I probably might get some giveaways in, potentially, 10-20k, so I can send you the coins over that way, and all that stuff that'll probably go on, and I might be doing some squad builders as I update my squad before Christmas. And today we're actually going to be doing, I should probably mention it, we're going to be doing a cheap starter squad. This squad cost me 7,000 coins, so pretty much most players after a week should have at least 7,000 coins. You can get this squad very, very easily, and if you're playing the web up, you might be able to get a squad now. So let's just get in with the squad, and we're going to start with the goalkeeper. I've also done starting my BPL squads, but that I've only got 3 players for that. So we're just going to start off with our Bundesliga goalkeeper, which is going to be Berkey. Yeah, we're going to be having Berkey in goal. His stats look pretty good. Pretty good, they're not too bad. Let's just get into the, where's the buy, player details there. He's got decent diving reflexes for a non-rat, and he's got pretty decent handling positioning. I only put him for 550 coins, so he looks pretty decent for 550 coins. And going into the two centre-backs, obviously we wish that Rudiger would still be in the Bundesliga, but he's not, he's gone to the Serie A. Otherwise I probably would have had him in, but we've had to go with Nastasic as my first defender if it decides to go in. And Bungert, bit of a weird name, but he has 81 defending and 71 pace, so, and he's cheap anyway, so I have to go with him. Nastasic, I think, is one of my most expensive players at, how much did I buy him for? 700 coins. I was going to get him for 450, but then someone out bought me, which is annoying. But anyway, 700 coins is fine anyway. Bunga, I've already said, he's just got 81 defending and 71 pace. He looks like a pretty good centre back for 550 coins. So, and the left back is pretty much a very good deal. I managed to get Bernat. If it goes in, yeah, Bernat. He's selling for what, 700 coins, and I managed to get him up for 450 coins. I would have got him anyway, because I've had 2,000 coins spare, so I built a bit of a BPL squad. But for that type of player, he's, especially Bayern Munich and Spanish, he's got a very good club and a very good nation. 400 coins, that's just, it's quite a deal, you've got to say. And going into the right position, we have, who is it? Oh, it's this Polish guy who's got 86 pace. That's the only reason I bought him, is because he's got 86 pace. I don't care about the other stats, he's got 86 pace. It's a bit self-explanatory. Going into the first centre mid, we have Genter. He has pretty all-round stats apart from his pace, and pace doesn't matter too much, although I did just go for a player that has 86 pace, but anyway, I've got a player with 60 pace, I think it is, yeah, but he's got pretty decent physical and defending, and he's got good shot and passing for a non-rare, so he just stick that midfield until, these players aren't going to stay here for long, because I'm going to be getting, as soon as it hits Thursday, I'm going to be getting 4,600 FIFA points, and I'm going to be open those packs and hoping to gain like players like Balarabi into my side and all that. So yeah, pretty much, I'm not going to be able to record it. I could do it on the web app, but I want to see the animation. I haven't really done that yet. I might record some of my foot draft packs that I get. So yeah, let's go into the second centimeters. Second centre mid, we have Castro, which I thought was pretty decent for, I think I bought him for 900 coins, and he's my most expensive player, but he was one of my favourite midfielders in the Bundesliga last season, and him playing for Dortmund is obviously going to make him a higher price, but I thought he was going to be rare, and yeah, so and look, he's only got 69-69, which is nearly giving him 70 overall stats plus some 80. So for 850 coins, he hopefully will be a good buy. going into the CAM position, his normal position for this CAM is a centre forward. I've transferred him to a CAM. Actually, I bought him for a CAM for a bit of coins, but Rafael as a CAM, he looks pretty decent with 85 dribbling and 79 passing, which is all you need for a CAM, really. A bit of dribbling and a bit of passing. Going to the right wing, he's not actually a right wing, he is a right mid. Let's just change that. And he has been quite popular throughout the last few years of FIFA, and it's Eduardo Vargas. As you might have seen there, he had 86 pace, 82 dribbling, and 76 shots for a non-rare. That is pretty decent. And going into the striker, he is, again, a centre-forward, but playing him at striker is Max Kruse. The only reason I bought him is because there's not many good Bundesliga strikers that are non-rare. And plus, I used, in FIFA 15, I did a player Rosagoro with myself, and I was at Borussia Mönchengladbach, and he was probably the main players. Obviously, he's now moved to Wolfsburg, but he was sort of a main player, and I really liked him, so I wanted to see how he goes in FIFA 16. And the left mid, I'm going with El Yanousi. 85 pace, 81 dribbling, pretty much all the only reason I went for him. Anyway, that is the squad there. If you did enjoy, hit the like button. If you're new around here, hit the subscribe button. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.